Today marks 4 years since the horrors of the Christchurch terror attack, when a gunman opened fire at two mosques, killing 51 people in a hateful rampage. This year, there's no official commemoration event, allowing families to gather in private instead. Thomas Mead met with some who wanted to share those moments.
They say grief changes over time, but it never fully leaves. At the cemetery this morning, the bond between mother and son was unbreakable, even in death.
I will just sit and talk to him and pray to him.
It's been 4 years since a gunman opened fire in Christchurch, killing as many Muslims as he could. But instead of the large events we've seen on other anniversaries, this year commemorations were held in private.
Commemorating deaths at certain point of time is not something that we practice.
In its place, a group of widows have organised a Unity Week, inviting the public to events in Christchurch.
This year's theme is Unity Begins With You. So sit down and think and reflect about what we can say, what we can do, what we can give to contribute towards unity or building unity.
While across town in Linwood, a new future was being forged. The old mosque is scheduled for demolition and will soon be replaced by a multi-million dollar complex funded by donations.
We believe it will really release people from the trauma we've gone through and the pain people have suffered.
But for many of the families, the past still looms large. Yana Azat flew down from Auckland to honour her son Hussein Alumari, who is one of the 51.
He was very brave. Yeah, very brave.
And as time continues, the responsibility rests with all of us to never forget the lessons of March 15.
And while victims from 2019 are being remembered, there was a reminder today of some of the hate the community's been fighting. Thomas Mead is with us. Thomas, what can you tell us about this?
Well, in some very unfortunate timing, a bizarre scheduling incident, really. A man who threatened to attack both mosques 2 years ago happened to appear in court this afternoon. In that incident, this man was previously arrested, charged and sentenced to intensive supervision for writing posts online where he essentially threatened to car bomb two of the mosques around one of the anniversaries. He appeared today. There was some ongoing discussion around name suppression. We can't show you his face. TVNZ has now for some time been filing submissions hoping to lift that name suppression in the public interest, but those arguments are ongoing. His defence team claims that he has been rehabilitated, is on the path to rehabilitation. But for the Christchurch Muslim community, it is a very unfortunate reminder that there are still some pockets of hate out there. Some are telling us that they are now starting to feel forgotten, and that initial outpouring of love and support they felt after the attacks is starting to wane with the passing of time. So if anyone is watching the story tonight thinking, how can I get involved? What can I do? Perhaps Unity Week is a place to start. And if you can't get along to those events in Christchurch, I think all of us can take some time to welcome someone new and to have some new discussions sometimes. So something to think about for everyone at home tonight.
Ngā mihi nui. Thanks very much, Thomas.